think it wasn't until that I got accepted, that's when kind of the bombshell hit that, hey, I'm gonna be dedicating my 4 years and a lot of money towards this education. And that's when I sort of started researching all of the options that were available to me to help pay for vet school. And once I found like the Army's website, I was hooked. That was like, this is it, this is meant to be, you know, things just kind of fell into place.
I've always kind of wanted to do something in the military, but my mom, she was like, well, why don't you do ROTC? And I was like, well, I don't want to do ROTC and not do something veterinary related. I'd be doing something else.
So I'm a recipient of the Health Profession Scholarship Program, which basically means I applied during my first year of vet school, and they pay for my second, third, and fourth year, as well as a monthly stipend. So pretty sweet deal. After I graduate, I'll owe them 3 years of active duty service and then 5 years of reserve service.
So the HPSP Army Scholarship, it's essentially a three-year scholarship. You essentially just have to keep yourself in shape, go to whatever basic training they want you to, and then once every year you have something called active duty training. The initial application is 52 pages. And they ask everything about your life, like where you lived for the past 10 years, medical history, references for all of that.
They also send you up to a MEPS, which is basically a medical checkover. They check your range of motion, your height, your weight, physical requirements. And once you pass all those, then the jury sits in the spring and they announce who got the scholarship that spring. The Army does something great where they give you a free internship. After that 1 year internship, they give you your own clinic and you're responsible for all the hirings, firings, taking care of all the animals.
Your main priorities are the military working dogs and what's on base. So you're running the clinic on base and you're making sure that all of your technicians there are trained and whoever else is below you is trained and that they can do what they're supposed to, and you're running the day-to-day handlings of how the clinic's supposed to go.
I think that Virginia Maryland does a fantastic job at offering a lot of resources. So they do offer like a business club. So I'm in that, and they offer a few leadership courses over the course of the curriculum here. So I feel less overwhelmed than I did initially upon hearing that I would run my own clinic 2 years after graduating. The Army is so much more than just being a food inspector or being deployed overseas. You do such a wide range of things. They have like a great board certified pathology program that you can pursue on their dollar, which is pretty nice. Not only do you take care of all of their military working dogs and you're able to practice such a good standard of medicine, you can also, if say you don't want to be a clinician, you can go and say get your MPH and you can do more food safety, agroterrorism sort of things. There's a lot of pathways that you can take in the Army that I wish people were more aware of.